Hey guys, what's going on? Pete over here, Craigslist Hunter. Hope everybody's having a wonderful holidays. And today I want to talk to you guys about how to be a better picker. Yes, a better picker, that's what I mean. How to maximize your profits out there. So yes guys, today I want to talk to you about how to maximize your profits when you're picking out there. And I've been talking to a couple of my friends lately who do a lot of picking, but they're always kind of scared and stay away from stuff that it's broken. Me, on the other hand, as you guys know, if I can make a profit on anything, I'll buy it. So I always look for the broken stuff too, because a lot of times there's good opportunity, especially on items that are very, very expensive when they're new. And it doesn't mean if they are broken that they still won't bring good money. So I want to show you here a few things what I picked up recently and that they sold for pretty good profit, and I'll explain what was wrong with them and how much I got into them and what was the profit. Alright guys, here's the first item I want to show you. Picked this up off Craigslist. Actually took about 3 or 4 days before the guy came back to me on this one. When I saw this posting on Craigslist, he listed that the unit still works, but it has some issues. To contact him, he was asking $150 for it. So I sent him an email. He didn't respond like for a day. When he did respond to me, I offered him $100 for it. He came back at me that he's gotta have at least $125. And I sent him an email again. No, that's the best I can do is $100. It has some issues. I'm gonna have to fix it. Blah, blah, blah. So, and it went quiet like that. After a couple days, he contacted me again that he's willing to accept $100. So I went up and picked up the unit, brought it home, plugged it in, tested it out. Unit was working actually fine. There was 3 knobs on top. They were completely loose. Which I took it apart, tried to fix them, couldn't do it. You know, they were still working, but they were just loose. So I listed on eBay for $449, and in item condition I put down that the unit still works, but I'm selling strictly for parts, and please read the description. And I describe and pointed out in pictures which knobs are not working and what's going on with the unit. Now this unit is extremely expensive when it's new, and it's very sought after by the DJs. This unit sells for almost $1,000, like $950. So, you know, even when it's broken, something that is very popular, you can still sell it for very good money. As you can see here, you know, this unit went for $449, and I think I had this like for 3 or maybe 4 hour stops and it sold. So yeah, you gotta look for those broken items. There's always good money to get out of them. Don't be scared. So let's go to the next one. All right guys, so this one it's an Alpine amplifier for your car. I picked this one up for I think $499 at Goodwill. Kind of taking a chance on it. I kind of knew probably there's an issue if I'm finding this at Goodwill. So I brought it home, powered it up, and that's correct. It was not working, so my expectations were correct, but for $5, why not? I mean, the light still comes on the unit, gets power, but nothing comes out of any channel. So listed it for parts and repair, put it down that the unit still lights up. Now, with some of the units that they are either for repair or broken, you know, I start them up at the auction, like to do it in PM hours, late PM hours, and I start them at $1. You know, when I do the auction, then I definitely do all the shipping on it, just in case if it sells for small money, that my shipping is covered. Most of the time on Buy It Now, my shipping is free. So don't be scared to start something at $1. It creates a lot of buzz and interest in it, and people start bidding on it because it's so cheap. So I started this one at $1. It had 9 bids on it. And it sold for $31 with $8 shipping. So great little profit on that one. All right, guys, here is another one. It's Apple iPod Classic 5th generation, 80 gigabytes. You know, the 80, 120, and 160 gigabytes are very popular, especially the classic ones. I mean, you can load up a ton of music on them, and people love to buy them. Now, this one was listed on Craigslist. Lady wanted $35 on it, and she put it in the description that does not hold charge. The unit has to be powered on all the time in order to work. So, you know, I offered her $20, I think, for it, and we settled on $25. Was right by my house, went and picked it up for $25. And put it in description that the unit works and doesn't hold charge, has to be plugged in, and it was actually in pretty rough shape. As you can see here on the picture, it's got a lot of scratches, but function, no problems. Everything worked on it except, you know, the battery wouldn't hold charge. So once again, I listed this one at $1 starting auction with $5 for shipping. And look, created 24 bids on it. By the time it ended, sold for $99. So once again, you know, it doesn't mean if it's broken or something is not working correctly on it, that it's still not gonna bring good money. So this was pretty good profit, you know, $75 or so. Let's go to the next one. All right, so here we got very interesting find. It's a vintage 1949 Coleman lamp. I picked this up at the estate sale, and this was a funny story. When I got there, this was like a last day of estate sale, and it was pretty picked through, and there was hardly anything there that was very interesting for me. But I spotted two of these lamps, actually, and they had a price $10 each on them. Now, the one that you see in a picture right here, it was missing the globe, you know, the glass globe that you have there. Now, the second one next to it, they were identical, but the second one had the globe, but it was all banged up in the bottom, and the whole top, the green top, was completely rusted. So I offered $10 for both of them, and, you know, last day, guy had no problem, sold it to me. So I basically made one lamp out of two. They were identical, so I took the globe from the bad one, put it on this one, and basically I had $10 in it for in both of them. Listed for Buy It Now with free shipping, $79.95, and it didn't take long at all. I think it was maybe a day or two, and it sold right away. So this was a very nice find. You just got to be very creative, you know. If you can make some adjustment, fix something, or swap something around to make it look good and work, hey, why not, right? So that's what I mean, being a little bit creative, be a better picker out there. All right, let's go to the next one. That's going to be probably the last item I'm going to show you guys. Very interesting, too. All right, so this one, it's a Yamaha OB student model made in Japan. This was listed on Craigslist. I did have to drive for this one a little bit, and I decided to do that. It was probably about 40 minute ride each way, so pretty far for me. I usually don't go that far, but this lady had this listed for $100 on Craigslist, and it said needs cleaning. Now, you know, there's so many different models, but the ones specially made in Japan, older ones, they're really, really, you know, sought after models. So, you know, when I looked it up online, and in good condition, was selling anywhere between like $400 to $600. I mean, that was a pretty big spread. But But still, you know, worth my time going and checking it out. So, you know, made a call, made an appointment with her, went out there. And the problem was, I mean, you could blow into a unit and it was like plugged, like nothing would come out, you know. So I took my chance on it. I have a guy who works on my musical instrument. So I offered her $70. She didn't want to go for that. She was kind of stuck on that $100. I explained to her, listen, look how far I came. You know, it cost me $40 just to get to you and gas, which probably cost me about 20. But so we settled finally on $80. So I picked this up for $80. I took it to my guy. He took it apart and just needed a cleaning. You know, this was an older unit. And he cleaned it up for me, charged me $40 for the work that he did on a unit, cleaned it up, and actually changed one of the corks on it as well for a tight fit. And look at this, I did the same thing again with this one. Started at $1, 7 day auction. He cleaned it up nice for me. I put great conditions, so the unit, you know, was in really, really nice shape after he was done with it. Put $1,295 shipping. Look, 42 bids. Yeah, it went crazy. When something is worth a lot of money and you start it at $1, it creates this buzz. So don't be scared, you know, people are like, you're gonna list it for $1, you're gonna get, you know, screwed, somebody's gonna buy it, you lose your money. No, if you know if something is hot and it sells most of the time good, you know, you can put it up for $1. And this one had 42 bids on it, $1,295 shipping, great profit on this. You know, I made, you know what, $250 after everything is done. So yeah, guys, look for stuff like this. You know, when you are a picker, don't miss out on anything. When you walk into that thrift store and you only buying clothes, don't be stuck on clothing only. You already there, you made your trip. So look at different stuff, you know, and like I'm showing you here, even the broken things bring a lot of money. So be creative, spend extra few minutes when you're going through that store and scan items, because you never know. Sometimes, you know, things that you are 100% sure would never sell bring crazy money. So this was my tip for today. Actually two tips, right? The first one was buy used and broken things and you can still make money on them, and then list them again for $1 on auction, creates the buzz and you can make some money. So I hope you guys enjoyed the video. More coming soon. If you enjoyed it, please give me a like, thumbs up, you know, share it. And if you haven't subscribed to my channel yet, please do. More videos coming soon. Happy holidays, Merry Christmas, peace.